We read in Proverbs 8:17, if you love me, my love will be a blaze for you. Proverbs 8:17 says, if you love me, my love will abide in you. Jeremiah 31:3, if you seek me with your whole heart, you will definitely will find me. But you have an enemy, he will not allow you to seek all your energy on me. But he will divide. Why can't do this? Why can't do that? If you seek me with whole heart. Jeremiah 31:3. Hebrews 10:17. In the love of mine, you become a lovable being. To love God, your whole heart means what? Number one, by resisting the emotions. Our emotions, if you don't handle it, it will handle you. If we don't handle or lead our emotions, our emotions will handle us and lead us in its own way. So emotions are very important that are contrary to God's will. We have to resist every emotions that are contrary to God's will. Because our emotions are important and powerful part of our life. Our emotions are very, very important and powerful part of our life. So we should be cautious that our emotions do not take us away from God's will, to do contrary to the will of God. So we have to resist our emotion, see to it that they are not contrary to His will. Second, we should know they are God-given and can be used to love God, to love ourselves and to love others. Without loving God, I can't love myself. Without loving God and loving myself, I can't love others. The enemy's game is to make me zero, to make me loveless being, to make me to think that I am in need of something, I am empty. So he will put me to ulta, to love others and to love myself and then to love God, which is not going to take place. The moment I am trying to love others, that is the beginning, first stage, starting point, I am get stuck up with that love. Because love of the world, the love of karmic love, the sexual love, the emotional love, get stuck up. Once I love God, love myself, then I am in a position how to handle my emotions, my sex, and my desires. When I love God, and when I love myself as being loved by God, then I begin to handle my emotions, because basically I am in need of love and affection. And these emotions, basic needs of mine, can be directed by from where I begin. If I begin to love somebody, move to somebody, and from that to move to myself, and then move to God, this is the technique of the world. This is the technique of Satan, to take my mind, that girl looks nice, I can become friendly with her. Maybe that program may be good. I can become somebody. I can become a magician. Maybe I can study this one whereby I can become famous. So look at the world. Have passion for the world. To have passion to possess the things of the world. And then to enrich myself. And then to serve God. This is the worldly program, satanic programs. Whereas God's programs, God's way of leading His disciples is, you invest your time on His word, you move in the love of God, you enrich yourself in the love of God, and you experience that you are being loved by God. And once you know that you are loved by God, you are full in God, then give that love to one another. There you learn, you have still your desire, many type of desire, but you know how to handle your emotions. It is there you direct your emotions. In the world, the emotion pulls you. In God, your emotion is directed. The world pulls your emotions where you are incapable of handling your emotions. Your emotions become powerful, and even you become victim of your emotions. That is the worldly. Whereas in God, you are in a balanced state of mind. You direct your emotions. You use your emotions to the purpose for which you want to use. So our emotions are important and powerful part of our life. They are God given. They are powerful. If you don't use it in the right way, it can destroy you. It's like fire. If you move in the right direction, the fire can be used for many, many good things. Otherwise, it will burn you. So the enemy will not allow you. The moment you take the word, he will try to disturb you. The moment you invest time to know your God, how will you know? It is through word of God, nothing else. The more you invest your time on the word of God, so the word of God is the starting point. The more you invest your time on the word of God, the more you begin to know him, the more you begin to love him, the more you begin to hear him saying, you are treasure, you are precious, you are in need. I need you. I love you. Through you, I can accomplish higher things. So you begin to see God speaking to you, talking to you, forgiving you. Until then, you feel in the world, you feel guilty. In God, you feel you are forgiven. In the world, you feel you are sinner. In the Lord, you find that you are the child of God. So the father cannot afford to lose the child. The father may feel sad that the child has sinned, but the father goal is always to rebuild, repent, renew and restore are the stages in which God builds his children. Repent, renew and restore. In the world, you are a sinner. You cannot handle yourself by yourself. You are waste. God trusted you, and you are living your own life, guilt, and then better, you leave your God and find your own. And many people leave the priesthood, leave their way of life, leave their charism, and they begin to do many other things. Instead of, suppose we preaching the word of God, we go for something else. I become a teacher. I become something else. A social worker. So we have to be very, very careful. Our emotions are very important. So we diligently keep our heart focused. So building up our emotions means what? Directing our emotions means what? We diligently focused. So we see to it that I am focused. The moment I realize I am not focused, I come back. The moment I am realizing I am disturbed, then I understand my focus is disturbed. So I keep my life focused. Very important. So handling emotion means keeping focused. Leading my emotions to focused. And leading my emotion means we diligently keep our heart, number one, focused. Number two, we diligently keep our heart clean. We keep our heart clean. I want this heart. No, I don't want to do all these dirty things to hurt my God who loves me. And I am not meant to be a dirty man. And I am not meant to be to move out of my call and involve in it. The people, the moment they moved out of the fence God put, they were bitten by the snake that were waiting and enter into all kinds of problems that becomes part of my life. Some problems I can't even handle it because I move away from the fence of God. The moment I move away, I realize there are so many snakes waiting outside. So when I am inside, I see people drinking, I see people are sinning, all that. But the more I focus on Him, what He has given to me becomes a great treasure, and that I'll become cheap, nothing. But in the absence of the treasure of God, what outside world gives becomes tasty. Because I don't have Him, I try to have the world. The moment I don't delight in God, the moment I don't build up my emotions in God, I realize that I have to focus my emotions. I have to keep my emotions clean. When I don't do that, I feel empty. And I feel, since I don't have, let me have at least something. So I move towards, stretch out. When my hand is full, when I have biryani, why should I go for dal rice? But in the absence of biryani, I am feeling hungry, let me have at least that dal.